Hey everyone, this is Nick, and I got a question over on one of my lookup, zip code lookup videos from Jack DeYoung last week, and he wanted to know if there was a way that we could look up cities from a zip code that were not the primary city. So he wanted to know if there's a way that you could look up all of the possible cities that are associated with a single zip code in one. So right now, as we have it, the U.S. Postal Service database gives you the primary. I'm going to actually flip right over here to our database here. This is our XLOOKUP zip code template. If you go over to the zip code database tab, you can see that these are all the zip codes in the database. Then each of those zip codes is associated with a primary city. That's over here in column D. But then there's also another column of acceptable cities in column E. Now, sometimes those are just abbreviations of the primary city, but sometimes they're additional cities that might fall within a single zip code. So what Jack said over on YouTube was that he has over 2,000 zip codes that he needs to try and get all of the associated cities within those 2,000 or over 2,000 zip codes. So I wanted to see if there was a quicker way than going one row by row by row and really counting each of those acceptable cities. So let's go over. So I'm in here in our 2022 zip code lookup template. I'm going to go ahead and create a new tab over here. So we just created a new sheet. Just click that little plus sign down there that says new sheet. And this is my list of zip codes. I'm going to scroll down here and show you I have 2,000 zip codes here. And they're probably from a range of different cities. Let's go ahead and just make our own XLOOKUP table again from scratch. So this is going to be our column for our primary city. And then we're going to have acceptable cities here. So let's do our XLOOKUP function here, XLOOKUP. I'm going to point to the value that I want it to look up right there in cell A2, comma. Then we're going to go to our zip code database. We're going to look up the value from this column here. I'm going to push a comma, and then we're going to return the value that's in the primary city. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to close the parentheses. I'm also going to put an ampersand and an open quote, close quote, and that's just going to return a value of space if there's no value in there, which would be pretty nice. So I'm gonna go and click enter. And let's see, we got an error. What is this error? Oh, okay, looks like it's all good. This will be Littleton. Okay, let's do this for the acceptable cities too. Same formula, XLOOKUP. And you have to have Microsoft 365 to use XLOOKUP. You could do something similar with VLOOKUP if you had earlier versions. Okay, so XLOOKUP, we're gonna look up this value here, comma. Let's go over to our zip database. And I'm going to say look up the value in this column, comma, and we're going to return the values in this acceptable. Now I'm going to go ahead and push close parenthesis, ampersand, open quote, close quote, and then we're going to push enter. Okay, so now we have all of those acceptable cities. Now, the unfortunate part about this is that the acceptable cities, they don't return values in a single one city per column. They have all of these cities sort of concatenated together by commas. So we're going to deal with that in just a second here. But I want to first copy down this formula, this function formula, so that we can go get all of the cities associated with my zip code list here. I'm going to go ahead and double click this little arrow here, and that's going to fill down everything. So now we have, if I scroll down, you'll be able to see everything all there. Quick trick here, remember, just push control and then the down arrow, and that's going to take you to the last cell that's populated. So control down arrow, that's a really important fun little Excel trick there. Okay, so we have all of this. So let's go back up to the top. Now what I want to do is I'm going to use the text join function to join these two cells here so that everything associated with a single zip code is going to be in one cell for me, okay? So let's just go ahead and just call this text join. And we're going to use the text join function. This is one of the new functions for Microsoft 365 as well. So we're going to have equal sign, and we're going to say text join, open the parentheses, asking me for delimiter. And what I want to list as the delimiter is a comma. So I'm going to go ahead and open quote, type in a comma, close quote, and then I'm going to comma another thing. This says true, we want to ignore empty cells. So I do want to ignore empty cells. So I'm going to double click that true. Oops, let's see if it goes there. Perfect. And now I'm going to put another comma here. And now I want to join the two cells, join the text that's in these two cells. So I'm going to go ahead and take my mouse and just drag that over. We're going to close the parenthesis now. And I'm going to push enter. And now you can see all of my text from these two cells has been joined together and they're separated by commas. Okay, perfect. I'm going to do the same thing here. I'm going to double click this little arrow. It's going to fill all the way down. So now I have every single city associated with this single zip code. So now what I want to do is go ahead, and I'm going to actually use the unique function here. There's another function that we can do, and I'm going to say unique. Oh, I'm going to say this is my unique list. So what this is going to do is it's going to return a list of all the unique values in a single list. So right now you see Denver right here, but there's another Denver here. So we have a lot of repeats. So we want to make sure that we want to kind of make this list a little bit smaller. It's not going to be 2,000 cells anymore. So let's go ahead and type equals unique, open the parentheses, and I'm going to go ahead and push shift control down, and that's going to highlight the entire column here of my data. Let's go, just go back up so we can see what happens when I push enter. We're going to go ahead, and you don't need to do anything else for this one. I think you can just close the parentheses on this, and let's go ahead and do that. All right, so now if I scroll down, we will now see that in this unique list that we don't have nearly as many. So we go all the way down to 360. So there are 360 unique values here in this cell, but they are still things that are repeats. So there's a single cell for Denver, but then we also have the person who is in Denver, North Glen, Westminster, all of those zip codes there. So now what do we do? So now what we're going to do is I'm going to use an older Excel function here. I'm going to put all of this text to columns. So every single word in a cell is going to be separated into its own column here. And so what we're going to do is just highlight this cell, go up to the Data tab, and then I'm going to go ahead and click under Data Tools, select Text to Columns. And I'm going to keep on delimited. I'm going to say Next, and I'm going to say things are separated by a comma. So then I'm going to say Next again, and we're going to finish. Oops, and actually it didn't work because this is still a formula. So I'm gonna click on undo and show you what you need to do. So instead of having the formula here, we just need to have the value. So I'm gonna go ahead and push shift control down. We're gonna copy this, and then we're just gonna paste the values in. So let's go ahead and right click and then paste special, or you can just click right here, paste as values. So now when you look in the cell here, you can see in the formula bar, it's the actual values. It's no longer that unique formula. So it doesn't look like you can do that text to column function when there's a function or a formula in the cell. Okay, so let's go ahead. I'm just gonna push enter to get rid of the little lines there, dotted lines. Okay, we're gonna click on column E here, our unique list. We're gonna go back up to the data tools, text to column. Now we're gonna go ahead and say delimited, next. And now you can say, I'm going to separate it with a comma. So now you can, it gives me a little preview of what that's going to look like. It's going to take all of this text and separate them each into their own column. So we're going to go ahead and click next and then finish. All right. And now I have every single city in its own column right here. It's pretty cool. Okay. So now what we're going to do, but it could go all the way down here. Let's see what the last column is. This one is in column K. There's other ones. There's an easy trick that you can do right here is I'm just going to go ahead and highlight a bunch of columns. It can't possibly be more than R. I'm going to go ahead and click the filter button. And anytime there's any text in that column, we're going to get a little caret box here, a little filter box. And you can see that there's nothing in Q. But I'm going to go ahead and click here, and it looks like a blank in P. But then we have another blank here, another blank here. There might be something here, but it looks like maybe N is the last column here. But anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and, well, let me just scroll down and see what this looks like. No, it doesn't look like there's any data in O or P. And then this was our last cell right here. Okay, anyway, I think that's okay. What we're gonna do is I'm just gonna go ahead and get rid of any of the columns that don't have text. It doesn't really matter. It's just kind of a little preference thing. Okay, so N, I think that was our last one that has a city in it. Okay, perfect. So now what we're gonna do is I'm gonna get another unique list, but this time, let's see, I'm gonna call this the single list. But now what we're gonna do is we're gonna put in another array formula that puts everything into these columns into a single list, into a single column. So what we need to do here is we're gonna type in equal TOCOL. TOCOL returns the array as one column. So I'm gonna open that parenthesis, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click and drag all the way over here. Oh, actually we'll go to N because that's our final one. And since we only have 360 rows, I'm gonna just keep on dragging this down so you can see it, but you could also do that shift control down arrow key to get all the way down to the final piece of data. So we're gonna do this, and that looks like our final piece here. So now you have to click on the comma, and then we want it to ignore blanks. So I'm gonna say ignore blanks. We're gonna do another comma, And it doesn't matter, false or true, scan by row or column. This part doesn't matter, so I'm just gonna say true actually here. But if you did false, it would do return the same thing. Close the parenthesis, and now let's go up here, and I'm gonna push enter, and you'll see in column P, it's going to return a single list of values. Awesome. Now, okay, this is there's a lot of steps involved here, but it's quicker than going row by row and counting, I promise you. So let's here, in column P here, oops, let's get up here. Why can't we get over here? What I'm gonna do here, if I can highlight this, let's do that same thing with this row and just copy all of these values and paste them in as values so that we don't deal with that array formula anymore. So Control Shift down all the way, I'm gonna push copy, and then we're gonna go ahead and paste as values. Okay, so now all of these are pasted as values. I can work with these data. And let's go over here. I'm just gonna like scroll over so we have a little bit of room to work with. And now what I wanna do, this is almost perfect, but you can see that we have, there are lots of copies here because some of those acceptable cities are really just the same thing as the primary city. So I have two Denvers, two Centennials, you know, lots of different repeats there. So let's just go ahead. We could either do the unique formula again, or we could put this as a pivot table, but let's just try this as a unique formula again. Unique list, final. And I'm gonna go ahead and click equals unique. And then we're gonna go ahead and tell it which list we want it to pull from, close the parentheses and push enter. And now here is our unique list of cities. And it goes from those 2000 zip codes. Let's see how many unique cities we have. 264 cities, it looks like, maybe 263. And I'm gonna go ahead and do the same thing. I'm going to Control Shift down to copy. We're gonna paste this as value, so we're not dealing with that unique array formula anymore. I'm gonna paste that down there. And all right, so this is your unique cities. Now, if I wanted to do, now the thing is, it's still not 100% perfect because let's look down here. Colorado Springs, there's a abbreviation there for Colorado Springs. Colorado Springs there. If we had another zip code in which the full name Colorado Springs was a primary city attached with it, that would probably show up here too. So it's not 100% perfect. You're going to have to go through these if you don't want those abbreviations. But if you wanted every single possible abbreviation for an acceptable city, this would be one way to do it. Let's do another formula here and see how many of these cities we have. Let's do a sequence formula. So we're going to type equals sequence, and I'm going to say rows. How many rows do we have? Well, actually, no, I can't do sequence. Actually, this is how I could do a list if I knew exactly how many cities there were, but let's see if there's just like 243. I think I can do like this, and then in one column, and then it gives you a list there. I specified 243, so let's just see if 243, it still doesn't go all the way down, and I can actually, but now after this, since this is a list, I think what I can do, I guess I can't click and drag that. I'd have to do it as another list here. Let's go ahead and copy these. We're gonna paste them as values. Anytime you have a list here, Excel is smart. If I do 1, 2, 3 in succession and then double click this, it's going to fill with a numerical ordered list all the way down to the final piece of data in the cell that's adjacent to it or that stops down here. So this was already stopped. So I'm gonna go ahead and do another double click there. Okay, cool. So 263 of 263 acceptable versions of a city for that initial zip code list of 2000. So Jack DeYoung, I hope this helps. I know it was a little bit of a roundabout way, and I bet there are some Excel folks in the community who might have a way that's even easier to do it. But this was just the way that I thought about it. So I hope this video helps, and I hope you subscribe to our channel. Had a great time making this video and trying to figure out how we could get this single zip code list of all the acceptable cities into one single column. So go forth and PowerPoint and Excel and have a wonderful day.